So let's get started. By the way, my name is Stephanie Dietz. I'm a developer advocate at Vercel, and SvelteKit is kind of my area of expertise, so I'm really excited about this meetup. I'm going to give you a little overview of what Svelte and SvelteKit are in case you're not super familiar. Then I'll show you just the highlights of using SvelteKit on Vercel and the extra features you get. So first, I'm sure probably all of you know that Svelte is a framework, but it's not just any framework, it's a cool framework because it's actually a compiler. So instead of shipping a library to the browser and letting the client do all the work, Svelte actually compiles your code at the build time into a highly efficient JavaScript bundle. And it's vanilla JavaScript, so it's almost like a disappearing framework because you're not going to be able to detect it when it's deployed. So by doing this, it ships less code and it makes your application more efficient. So kind of what you should take away from all that is that Svelte creates really fast applications. And it doesn't just create fast applications, but it's fun to use. It's a relatively simple learning curve because Svelte components kind of look just like your average HTML file. If we take a look at it here, you can see you have a script tag where you use some JavaScript, you have your HTML, and if you wanted to add a style tag, do some CSS, you could do that also. So it's a pretty fun framework to use because there's not a whole lot of learning if you're familiar with JavaScript. Now, Svelte can do, you know, everything your basic framework can do, but it also has some really cool built-in features like animations, transitions, and state management, just to name a few. So now that we know what Svelte is, what is SvelteKit? Now you could think of SvelteKit kind of like what Next.js is for React. So it's built on top of Svelte and it comes with a built-in router and server-side rendering, has build optimizations and configurable rendering so you can render some of your code on the server using server-side rendering, some in the browser using client-side, or during the build using pre-render. And of course, SvelteKit has a lot of features. I'm not going to list all of them, but it just makes it's so fun to use SvelteKit, and it creates awesome web applications. So now I want to get into the benefits of using SvelteKit with Vercel. Now, I'm sure most of you are probably familiar with Vercel since you're here, but I will go over one of the most basic features Vercel offers, and like the main feature is that it deploys your applications super fast, and it does all the configuring for you. So to deploy a new project, you just click Add New and Project. And since you sign in with GitHub, Bitbucket, or GitLab, you can see all your repositories are right here. You just import the one you want to deploy and then click deploy, and it will deploy it for you in a matter of seconds. And that's all you have to do. Now, for the sake of this demo, I'm going to work from one of my side projects that I shipped recently. And I figured this would be a good one for this demo because it really exemplifies how well SvelteKit works when deployed with Vercel. So here, I'll give you a little demo of what it is. We use the OpenAI API to stream data, it's show recommendations, but from an edge function. So you can click some categories and you can give a description like must be on Netflix, curate my list, and we can watch as the data is streamed in from the OpenAI API. Now you'll notice it's streaming, so we watch as the data comes in instead of waiting for it to generate the entire response and then send it to us. We don't have to look at a loading screen. You'll also notice it was really fast, and that's because we're using edge functions. So how do we use edge functions? I'm glad you asked. Let's take a look at the code. Here we have an API route, and up here we have our config, and we're setting it to runtime edge. So when we deploy this to Vercel, this will be turned into an edge function. Now, not all of your API routes need to be edge functions. This one I did not configure it, so it's just going to be your basic server function. And the reason this works is because SvelteKit applications can be adapted to work on just about any serverless, platform, so such as Vercel. And you do this using adapters. So if we go into our svelteconfig.js file, you can see we're importing our adapter Vercel and using it. And this allows us to use all the features with Vercel. So now when you deploy this application, that edge function becomes an edge function or becomes a server function. Now what's cool about Vercel is anytime you make a commit, it will automatically detect that you made a change and it will redeploy your application for you. So if it's, how do I get back? Sorry, guys. So if you make a commit to your main branch, it's automatically going to redeploy your production. Otherwise, it's going to deploy to what we call a preview deployment. And so here you can see we have a branch and we made a commit. So if we check this out, you'll see that this is a preview deployment. So this is not in production. And we have this cool toolbar down here. So you can share this either with the whole team or anyone who has access to this link. And this just really tightens the feedback circle. So people can come to this, they can leave comments. So maybe this button isn't working. You can say, button doesn't work. And you can even add a screenshot so you know exactly what button you're talking about. And send. Now here you can see all the comments that have been made. You can respond to them, you can resolve them. And so now let's say you have your finalized version, you're ready to push this to production. Of course, you could just merge it into main and Vercel will detect this and redeploy your production branch. Or what you could do is back in our deployments, you could go to that branch and say promote to production. And it will promote this to production. So without even merging it into main, you can make this your production site. Now, every now and then, you're going to eventually, hopefully not, but push something to production that either breaks it or slows it down or introduces a bug. And you, of course, don't want your users to have to use this while you try to fix it. So Vercel has an awesome feature called rollbacks, which allow you to instantly roll back to a previous deployment. And it doesn't rebuild. So it truly is instant. So let's say this production deployment that I just did really slowed down our application. And we don't want our users to have to deal with that while we fix it. We can go back to main and say instant rollback, continue, confirm. And now instantly, without having to rebuild, we've rolled back to our previous deployment. And our users don't have to deal with this slow website while we fix it. Now, the very last feature I want to go over that Vercel offers is analytics. If you install analytics into your SvelteKit application, you get all of this data right off the bat. It tells you visitors, page views, the pages they're looking at, where they're coming from, the browsers they're using, where in the what countries they're in. It gives you all this information, and all you have to do is install it into your SvelteKit application. So I hope I did a decent job explaining not only why Svelte is so cool, but also how well it works with Vercel. I am going to pass the mic on to Rich, who will take it from here. One last thing I want to tell everyone, I hope you all test out Svelte on Vercel. And if you want to, we do have a templates marketplace with tons of templates. We have it for all frameworks, so I really recommend you check it out and get started with SvelteKit on Vercel today.